Asuran Militandyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaihevacha Patitanam Bhavan Hebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita and we're hearing how Narada Muni is searching for the person who has received the greatest mercy from the Lord. So he has come to Prahlad Maharaj. We're hearing how Prahlad Maharaj responds to Narada Muni describing him as being the person who's received the greatest mercy from the Lord.
Narada就来到了普拉达的面前，然后我们听到普拉达他是如何回答Narada对他的形容，Narada形容他是得到了主的最大的仁慈的人。
So we're up to text number 10. So Narada Muni describes how Prahlad Maharaj agreed to take the throne of his father, Hiranyakashipu, who had been killed by Lord Nrisingadev.
Narada就形容说，Prahlad已经答应了接受继承他的父亲的王位，他的父亲是被Nrisingadev所杀。And
Prahlad Maharaj describes to Lord Nrisingadev that he's only accepting the throne with the intention that he can do good, he can deliver all the people under his rule.
而且普拉达呢，告诉主尼沙德夫说，他这么做呢，只是为了帮助那些就是在他统治下面的人民，来帮助他们。And
while Prahlad is sitting on the royal throne, he's still fixed in meditation on Lord Nrisingadev.
当普拉达坐在他的王座上的时候，他仍然专注地在冥想着主尼沙德夫。
Actually, Prahlad was reluctant to accept the throne, but he decided to do it for the benefit of others.
事实上，Prahlad并不情愿来接受这个国王的宝座，但他这么做呢，只是为了他是有所意图的。Prahlad
considered that if he could deliver all the people in the universe, then it would satisfy the Supreme Lord.
Prahlad 认为，倘若他这样能够帮助拯救宇宙间的所有生命，那么他这样就能够取悦了主。Prahlad
had already refused to go back to the spiritual world.
Prahlad 已经拒绝回到灵性世界。But
still, he accepted this invitation to sit on the throne and to rule a kingdom.
但他却接受了这个坐在宝座上统治王国的邀请。
And he did this because in his heart he had the desire to free the people of the world from suffering in the material world.
他之所以这样做，是因为他的内心深处，他渴望能够
把世人从他们的痛苦当中拯救出来。And he didn't worry that by sitting on the throne, he would have to be involved in politics. He didn't worry about that.
他也不担心，即便是他坐在宝座上，他可能要卷入一些政治活动，他也无所谓。
He knew it, you know, being the king, being the ruler, he'd have to deal with different political issues.
身为国王，他肯定要处理各种政务。
But he was confident that he could continue to meditate on the personality of Godhead.
但是他十分自信，他能够持续的冥想至尊性格神手。
And he was sure that the Lord would always protect him from any dangers in ruling the world.
而且他确信主能够保护他，免于在统治世界的时候遇到的各种危难。
And Prahlad prays to Lord Nrisingadev that he prays to Lord Nrisingadev that you're always situated on the other side.Of the river of death.
Prahlad 就这样赞美主尼舍德夫说：“您恒常的超然处在死亡之河的对岸。”
And we're suffering. We're suffering because of our activities. Our own activities are the cause of our suffering. We're on the other side of the river.
而我们由于自己过往的活动，我们正在。死亡之对岸，死亡之河的对岸，在这里受苦。
We're fallen in the river of birth and death. We're suffering all the pains and eating horrible things.
我们堕入了这个痛苦的生死之洋，生死的河流当中呢，而且正在吃着这个各种可怕的食物。
So Prahlad prays to Lord Nrisingadev, kindly look on us.Don't just look upon me, but look upon all the other living entities who are suffering in this world, and by your mercy, deliver them.
Prahlad 向主尼辛哈德夫祈祷说：“请仁慈的瞥视我们，不仅仅是瞥视我自己，还要去瞥视所有那些受苦之人。即使您无缘的仁慈和怜悯，请拯救他们吧。”
Okay.So material existence is compared. Prahlad Maharaj compares the material existence to a river called the Vaitarani.
Prahlad 把物质存在比喻为一条名叫 Vaitarani 的河流。
And that's actually the gateway to death.
这条河流是通往死亡的大门。
Material life is full of suffering, and life in the lower regions of the universe is a lot of suffering.
物质生活充满着苦难，而在低等宇宙的低等区域呢，那里的痛苦更加严重。
So Prahlad speaks, like he's afraid, like he's in fear of all the troubles, but he knows he can escape birth and death by taking shelter of the Lord.
Prahlad 开口讲话的时候好像是恐惧各种麻烦一样，但实际上他并不惧怕生死。
So Prahlad pretends that he's like most people in the material world. Most people in the material world, they make friends and enemies, and they get bewildered by all kinds of situations in the material world. They make distinctions, who's their friend and who's their enemy. So Prahlad appears to be like that, but actually,He's not.
Prahlad 说话的时候呢，就把自己装成一个普通人那样， 好像是他做出在世人当中做出区分，哪位是敌人，哪位是朋友，而且就在各种各样的处境当中深陷困惑，他把自己打扮成这样的人。
And Prahlad knows Lord Nrisingadev situated on the other side of the Vaitarani River. Or in other words, he is eternally free in the realm. He's in Vaikuntha.
Prahlad 赞美主，说主尼沙德夫是处在Vaitarani 河流的对岸，他实际上呢，他是处在百昆塔星球。
So Prahlad knows all the suffering which is there in the material world, and he requests Lord Nrisingadev to carry the people who, from this material world, to carry them across the river to safety.
Prahlad 深知世人的苦难，他祈祷，主能够把世人从物质世界给带到安全的对地带。
And Prahlad Maharaj prays to Lord Nrisingadev that he says, I know it's not difficult for you to deliver everyone because you're managing the affairs of the universe.
Prahlad 对主尼沙德夫说，我知道对您来说拯救世人并不难，因为您是管理着宇宙的事物。
You're the friend of all the suffering people, and for great personalities, you're the greatest of all personalities. It's necessary for you to show mercy to us foolish people.
你是受苦的众生的朋友，而且对于像您这样的大人物来说，您就有必要向我们这些蠢人展示您的仁慈。
So I think that you should show your mercy to persons like us who are engaged in your service.
我认为您应当向我们这样的人展示无缘的仁慈，而我们正在从事着为您做服务。
So Prahlad addresses Lord Nrisingadev as the spiritual master of all souls.
Prahlad 称呼主尼辛哈是所有灵魂的灵性导师。
So in this way he shows it's quite proper for Lord Nrisingadev to show mercy to everyone without any exception.
对于主尼辛哈德夫而言，毫无分辨的向所有生物展示仁慈，这是相当的恰如其分的。
For the Lord to deliver everyone in material existence, it's not a big effort for him, because he creates and he maintains and destroys the whole universe.
对于主，去拯救存在当中的每个灵魂，并不是是不会吹灰之力的，因为他创造、维系并且毁灭了宇宙。
And doing all that work, creation, maintenance, and destruction is just a pastime for him. It's just like it's no effort for him.
这么做对他而言只是一个逍遥时光，他不需要费力气。
So it's not much effort at all for the Lord to deliver his devotees who are engaged in their service, in his service. The Lord can deliver his devotees and also the servants of the devotees, like Prahlad.
对于主而言，去拯救那些为他从事服务以及身为他的仆人，像普拉德这样的仆人，那是不费吹灰之力的。
And Prahlad considers himself to be a demon who is fallen, but his only good quality is that he's a disciple of Narada Muni.
普拉德自视为一个堕落的恶魔，他唯一的优点就是他身为Narada Muni的门徒。
So Narada Muni is continuing to speak to Prahlad Maharaj to describe about some of the wonderful activities of Prahlad.
Narada 就继续向 Prahlad 描述他的奇妙的品质。
And he says that one time you went to the Naimisharanya forest to have darshan of Lord Narayan, who is known as the Lord in the yellow dress.
一次您去了Naimisha森林去见主Narayan，主Narayan以身穿黄衣的主而闻名。
And while you were on the road, you had a battle. You actually satisfied the Lord. You had a fight with him and you satisfied him. And at that time the Lord told you, he personally told you, yes, I am always conquered by you.
在路上您和主进行了一场战斗，满足了主，主告诉你，对您说，是的，我总是被你所征服。
So it happened that one time Prahlad took a trip to go to Naimisharanya to see the Lord Narayan, who is also known as Pita Vasa, which means one who wears a yellow dress.
有一次, Prahlad 就去 Naimisharanya 去见主 Narayana, 主 Narayana 另外一个名字是 Pita Vasa。
So while traveling on the road, when Prahlad was on the road there, on the road to Naimisharanya, he met this unusual person who was dressed like, an austere renunciate, but he was carrying a warrior's bow and arrow, and arrows also.
Prahlad 在路上旅行之际，他遇见了一位奇怪的相貌奇怪的人。他的穿着呢，像一位苦行的弃绝者，但是却拿着一个武士的弓和箭。So
Prahlad saw the contradiction in the dress of the man. That the man, on one hand, is dressed like a renunciate, but at the same time, is carrying a bow and arrows. So Prahlad considered that he must be some kind of hypocrite who is abusing the actual principles of religion.
Prahlad就从这个人的奇怪的穿着当中呢，就断定这个人一定是个伪君子，因为他穿的像一个苦行者，却拿着武士的弓箭，所以他一定是践踏了宗教原则。
So Prahlad began to fight with him, and he began to fight with the sannyasi. Prahlad vowed, "I swear I shall defeat you." But they fought for several days, and Prahlad Maharaj couldn't defeat him.
他们激战了连续好几天, Prahlad 无法打败对手。
So one morning, before they began to fight the battle, Prahlad was worshipping his personal deity.
一天清晨,在展开战斗之前, Prahlad 在崇拜他的私人神像。
But at that time, he saw the opponent, the person he was fighting, that sannyasi who he was fighting, he saw him standing nearby, and he was wearing the same kind of garland, the same garland which he had offered to his own deity.
突然之间,他看见他的对手就站在附近,脖子上戴着他供奉给神像的同样的花环。So
then Prahlad suddenly realized and he recognized that that sannyasi, the stranger, was actually Lord Narayan himself.
普拉德恍然大悟，那位，三尼亚森那位奇怪的人就是主本人。
So then, Prahlad offered prayers to the sannyasi with all of his ability. He offered prayers and tried to satisfy him.
于是, Prahlad 便就是全力以赴的向主献上了祷文, 试图来取悦满足主。
And at that time, the Lord then touched Prahlad with his lotus hand and took away all the tiredness from Prahlad, because Prahlad had been fighting for many days, so he was tired. But when the Lord placed his lotus hand on his head, he took away all of his fatigue and took away all of the anxiety.
主呢，于是就用他的莲花手触碰了Prahlad，这个触碰呢，就是使得Prahlad一扫几天来与主对决。 产生的疲劳感，已经产生的焦虑。
So Prahlad asked the Lord, what should he do now? Because he'd broken the duty of a kshatriya. He'd made a promise, but he was not able to keep his promise. So he asked the Lord, what should he do?
Prahlad 于是就问主，询问主，他现在该如何是好？因为他身为一个刹帝利，他已经立下了誓言要打败对手，可是现在却无法实现诺言。
So he had made the promise that he was going to defeat his opponent, but now he realized he can't defeat the Lord.
他曾经发誓他要打败对手，但是他明白他是无法打败主本人的。So
then the Lord told him, he told Prahlad Maharaj, he said, I'm fully satisfied by fighting with you. And he told Prahlad Maharaj, I am always defeated by you.
主就对Prahlad说，他与他作战非常的满意，这场战斗。 使他心满意足，并且主告诉普拉德说：“我总是被你所击败。”So
when Narada said this, Narada was in ecstasy in devotion, and he began to dance.
嗯，Narada重复这一事件的时候，他立刻就陷入狂喜当中，并且开始起舞。And
Narada began to shout, "Conquered by us!"
拿达大声地呼喊道，被我们征服了。So
the point is, Narada is describing that the victory was not just for Prahlad Maharaj, but for all the devotees of Lord Narayan.
拿达的这个呼喊呢，实际上他的意思就是不仅仅是他本人，而且是。 针对的是主Narayan的所有的奉献者。So
that's why Narada is so happy that the Lord is always conquered by his pure devotees.
Narada非常的高兴，因为主，他总是被他的纯粹奉献者所征服。So
Narada continues speaking to Prahlad Maharaj, and he tells Prahlad, he said, why should I say that Lord Mukunda has been conquered only by you?
Narada 继续说道，为什么我要说主母昆达只是被你所征服了呢？
Your grandson, Bali Maharaj, he is the chief of the demon of the Daijas. He's also conquered the Lord.
你的孙子巴利马拉，他是戴提亚的首领，他也征服了主。And
Bali Maharaj keeps the Lord there as his doorman.
巴利马拉使得主成为了他的守门人。
Bali conquered the Lord, and because he got control over him. And Lord Vimana came there to serve Bali Maharaj as a doorkeeper.
Bali 征服了主, 因为他控制了主, 使得主把妈的队伍成了他的保安。
And Bali is the leader of the Daityas, who are the enemies of Lord Vishnu's devotees.
Bali是 Daitya们的首领, 而Daitya们则是主Vishnu的死敌。
So this was only by the special favor of the Lord that he got that opportunity.
只是因为主的特殊的恩慈呢，他才得到这种机会。
Prahlad Maharaj offered prayers to Lord Vimanadev, saying that you are worshipped even by Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. They worship your lotus feet.
So he said to Lord Vimanadev, 你在全宇宙受到崇拜, 甚至主 Brahma, 主 Shiva 也崇拜您的莲花族。
And although you're such a great person, you've kindly promised to protect us, the demons.
尽管你是这样一个伟大的人物, 你却好心地答应能保护我们这些恶魔们。
So you're giving kindness to me more than you ever gave even to Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva or the Goddess of Fortune or any other demigod. You're giving the special kindness to us who are demons.
你给我们这些恶魔的仁慈呢, 甚至都超过了给予主 Brahma, 主 Shiva, 幸运女神和其他半世人的仁慈。
And then also there's a section in the Skanda Purana which describes the glories of Dwarka Dham.
在 Skanda Purana 往事书当中呢，有一个章节描述了 Dwarka 圣地的荣耀。
Because Dwarka one time got attacked by 10 powerful daityas.
Dwarka 一度受到十位强大有力的Daitya的进攻。
The Daityas are demons, you know.
Daitya就是恶魔。
So the committee of the residents of Dwarka were all, the committee was headed by Durvasa Rishi. They were all in distress. So they went to the abode of Bali. They went to Bali Maharaj's palace.
以Dwarsa Rishi为首的这个居民的委员会, 他们就去了，就是在痛苦当中呢，就去了巴黎的居所。
And Durvasa begged Lord Vimanadev, because Lord Vimanadev is there at Bali Maharaj's palace. So Durvasa Muni came all the way from Dwarka to beg Lord Vimanadev to come to Dwarka to defend them.
因为主Vimanadev就在巴里Maharaj的居所，因此Durvasa Muni就千里迢迢去了那里，恳求主Vimanadev呢来Dwarka来保卫他们。
But the Lord told them, Lord Vimanadev said, that he said, I'm not independent. He said, I've been purchased by the pure devotee of Bali Maharaj.
但是主回答朵尔萨穆尼说，我一点也不独立，我已经被巴利玛哈拉的纯粹的奉爱所收买了。
I have to carry out the orders of Bali Maharaj. I cannot just do what I like.
我必须要执行巴利玛哈拉的命令，我不能随心所欲。He
said, he said to Durvasa, he said, oh, you're my dear Brahmana. He said, please go to the Bali Maharaj, go to the demon Bali, who is the son of Virochan, and ask him And if he orders me, then I shall at once go and do whatever you want.
主法门的贝布就告诉多尔塞牧女说，我亲爱的婆罗门呐，请你去找巴利，他是维柔产的儿子，如果他对我下达了命令，我将立刻去做你要求我做的事情。
But when Durvasa came and asked Bali Maharaj, Bali Maharaj refused. He said, no, I'm not going to give Lord Vamanadeva permission to leave.
但是当 Durvasa 向 Bali Maharaj 提出了这个恳求的时候，却遭到了拒绝。巴利说，不，我不允许主 Vamanadeva 离开这个星球 Sutaloka.
Yeah, I need him to stay here.In Sutala Loka.
我需要他停留在 Sutala Loka.
And Durvasa said, I'm going to fast to death if you don't give him to us.
Durvasa 回答说，如果你不把他交给我们的话，我就会绝食致死。
But Bali Maharaj told him, they said, whatever you want, you can do.Whatever you have in mind, do that. But I shall never give up the lotus feet of the Lord.
巴利还告诉他说，如果你有什么心愿的话，你就去做吧。但是我是永远不会放弃主的两只莲花足的。
Lord Vamanadeva, the lotus feet of Lord Vamanadeva are worshipped by Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and all the demigods. They all bow down to him, and I'm not going to give him up.
主 Vamanadeva 的莲花足受到了主 Brahma、主 Shiva 和所有其他半神人的顶拜，我是不会放弃他们的。
So Narada Muni says to Prahlad Maharaj, from now on, I intend to stay here permanently with you.
Who is saying that?
Narada Muni is saying to Prahlad.
Okay. So Narada Muni 继续对 Prahlad 说道，从现在开始，我希望在这里永恒地和你待在一起。
And by your power, I will be able to overcome the curse I received from Daksha and others.
藉着您的力量，我肯定能够克服从 Daksha 和其他的人的那里发出的诅咒。
Because Narada Muni had been cursed by different people. One of them was Daksha.And there were other people, they had all cursed Narada Muni. And the curse was that he would not be able to stay in one place for more than a short time.
Narada Muni 曾经遭到过 Daksha 和其他几个人的诅咒。他们诅咒 Narada Muni 说他无法在一个地方停留的时间超过一小段的时间。
What happened, Daksha had many sons, but when the sons went, Daksha wanted to get all of his sons married, and before the marriage, he sent them to do some austerity and penance to purify themselves so that they could come back and get married and produce good children. But what happened was when they went to do their meditation and austerities, Narada Muni met them, and Narada Muni preached to them, and he convinced them not to go home.
就有一次呢，Daksha 他有一些儿子，他希望他的这些儿子们都结婚，但是他在他们结婚之前呢，他希望这些儿子们都去苦修，得到净化，他们要忏悔，被净化之后，他们返回之后呢，可以结婚。可以生下后代，但这些儿子们他们都去冥想了，他们从事苦行，他们遇到了 Narada Muni， Narada Muni 呢就向他们传教说，向他们传教，然后劝说了他们，使得他们没有回家。
Yeah, they renounced the material world.
Daksha 的这些儿子们，他
And this happened twice. The first group of sons, there were 10,000 sons. And then the second group of sons, there were 1,000 sons. And each time Narada Muni had preached to them and convinced them not to go home to get married.
达克夏呢，曾经有两波儿子，第一波儿子呢有十万个儿子，第二次呢是一千个儿子，第一次是十一万个，第二次是一千个儿子，结果都得，Narada Muni就向他们传教，就说服了他们再也不要回家了。So
when Daksha heard what had happened to his sons, then Daksha said that Narada Muni, you're a rascal. And you do not know how to behave towards others.
当达克夏听说到这个消息之后呢，他就勃然大怒，他就对纳达姆尼说：“纳达，你是一个恶棍，你不知道什么是正确的行为举止。”So
you can travel all over the universe, but I curse you to have no residence anywhere.
你可以在全宇宙上下旅行，但是我诅咒你在任何一个地方都没有自己的居所。So
that was one curse, and then there was another curse also, which is described how Narada got cursed by he got cursed by old age, who was the daughter of time.
所以刚才是其中一个诅咒。 还有另外一个诅咒是由时间的女儿，也就是老年年迈老年所发出的诅咒。So
it's described in the allegorical story of King Puranjan.
这个是一个比喻性的象征性的故事，是有关于Puranjana的国王的象征性故事。So
old age, who was the daughter of time. She had approached Narada Muni and she wanted to marry him, but he refused her.
时间的女儿，也就是老年，她接近了Narada Muni，希望她能娶自己，但是却遭到了拒绝。So
she was angry at Narada because he wouldn't marry her, so she cursed him that you will not be able to stay in one place for a long time.
他因为被拒绝，所以非常生气，便诅咒Narada Muni说：“你将不能在一个地方停留很长时间。”So
we've heard Narada Muni praise Prahlad. Now we're going to hear how Prahlad refutes Narada's praise. In other words, Prahlad, he's going to deny it. Prahlad will explain that really I'm not a great devotee.
我们刚才听到的是Narada对Prahlad的赞扬，接下来我们会听到Prahlad他是如何反驳Narada对他的赞扬，他矢口否认自己是伟大的奉献者。So
when Prahlad was hearing Narada Muni glorify him, Prahlad felt embarrassed and he didn't like it and he lowered his head. He was embarrassed.
当普拉德听到Narada Muni对他的赞美之言辞的时候，他感到非常的难堪难为情，他就在Narada面前低下了头。He
bowed down before Narada Muni, and with great respect in a quiet voice, Prahlad Maharaj began to speak to Narada.
他毕恭毕敬的就以一种柔和的声音。
Actually, Prahlad thought that this Narada Muni, he's just teasing me. That what he's speaking is just, it's impossible. He's just trying, he's just making a fool of me. He's teasing me.
Prahlad以为Narada这番话呢，实际上在逗弄他，逗他玩儿，因为对他而 而言的这一切呢，都是不可能的。他一定是在拿他取笑，开玩笑。At
the same time, Prahlad is speaking very respectfully because Narada Muni is his Diksha Guru. Narada Muni had given a lot of instruction to Prahlad Maharaj, so he has to be very respectful in dealing with and speaking to him.
与此同时，因为那儿的是普拉的孤儒。 所以他必须在跟他讲话的时候呢，毕恭毕敬。But
because he's his guru, so he addressed him with proper respect. And if he hadn't been his guru, then Prahlad might have got angry and shouted at him in a louder voice. But because he's his guru, he spoke softly.
所以在一位值得尊重的人面前呢，Prahlad呢，他必须要克制自己。如果不是他的guru的话，Prahlad本来会就会吵冲着他大吼叫了。So
Prahlad Maharaj says to Narada, he says, "Oh my dear Lord and spiritual master," he said, "please think again about everything you have said."
Prahlad 对Narada说。 我亲爱的主人和灵性导师啊，请你再重新考虑您所说的话吧。A
young boy cannot understand correctly about devotional service to Krishna.
一个年轻的男孩子是无法正确的理解对主Krishna的奉献服务的。To
properly understand devotional service, we have to have some maturity, mature understanding. Bhakti yoga is not just some external practice, but it's the actual use of our faculties, the use of our faculties to understand of the self. In other words, it's internal. It's not just doing things externally, but there has to be the proper attitude internally.
正确的执行奉献服务是需要成熟的理解力的，因为奉爱瑜伽并不是一个外形式，换言之，它并不是一个外在的活动，仅仅是外在的活动，它也是一个内在的态度。Just
like young children, before they become. Before they awaken, before they become intelligent, while they're still young children, they cannot understand what's required to do devotional service.
一个就是年轻的小孩子们，他们是不能理解，就是去执行奉爱服务的条件是什么。
There may be some exceptions, like a very special family of great sages or special devotees. But generally, Prahlad considers himself that he's uncivilized and born in a demon family, and he cannot claim to be like that.
就是在那些圣人们，还有圣洁奉献者的家庭当中的那些高度的有文化的家庭当中的子女，但是Prahlad认为自己他是一个被开化的恶魔，他不属于这个行列。So
Prahlad Maharaj says, when we get instructions from great souls, these instructions have the power to awaken our understanding, higher understanding.
Prahlad 说，当一个人从伟大的灵魂那里接受到训示的时候，那些训示便有力量，能够唤醒一个人更高的理解力。And
with these instructions, then we're able to engage in devotional service to the Supreme Lord.
有了这些训示之后，人便可以开始从事于对至尊主的奉献服务了。So
Prahlad Maharaj said, it's not a sign of greatness that an ordinary person like myself can see can see that despite so many disturbances, we can get spiritual, and there can be spiritual enlightenment.
Vlad 呢就继续说，像我这样的普通人之所以能够忍受那些可怕的骚扰，并且得到灵性的启发，这个并不是一个伟大的标志。
We can to give spiritual enlightenment to children doesn't mean the children are special. It's just the mercy of the Lord.
能给这些孩子们启迪，这并不不意味着这些孩子有什么特殊之处，它只是主的仁慈而已。
People show compassion to the suffering souls.Or to show compassion to suffering souls and to refuse liberation if it's offered to us, that is not a sign of greatness.
向受苦的灵魂们展示怜悯之情，或者拒绝得到解脱的赐福，这并不是一个伟大的迹象。
So Prahlad has personal experience.He has personal experience of the great benefit of associating with a pure devotee, because Prahlad had associated with Narada Muni.
Prahlad 对于与一个伟大的奉献者的片刻联谊带来的好处有切身的体验，因为他曾经拥有过这样的联谊。
So Prahlad describes that all whatever spiritual assets he has.It is all the mercy of Narada Muni.
Prahlad 描述说，他拥有的所有灵性的资产，只是由于 Narada 的仁慈。
And it was Narada Muni who gave him transcendental knowledge and guided him on the path of devotional service.
正是 Narada 赐予了他超然的知识，并且在奉爱服务的正确道路上引领着他。
And a person has matured in understanding when he realizes that what we think are the four goals of life are ultimately not enough. That means we've become mature. When we understand that things like religion, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation are not enough,That is a sign that we've actually matured.
当人意识到生活的四项基本的目标，也就是世俗的宗教、经济发展、感官享乐以及非人格的解脱，那都是还不够的时候，他这种理解力是成熟的理解力。
So at that time, a person can realize the actual value of devotional service to the Lord, and he can appreciate the Lord's devotees.
在那个时候，他就能真正的欣赏对主的奉献福德价值所在，并且欣赏主的奉献者的价值。
So Prahlad preached very strongly to the sons of all the other demons.
Prahlad 向恶魔的其他恶魔的孩子们，非常强有力的传教。
And he behaved just like a self-realized soul. He was dancing and singing in ecstasy.And he was merciful to the suffering conditioned souls, and he refused liberation, even when Lord Narsingadev offered it.
和辣的行为就好像一位自我觉悟了的圣人，他在狂喜当中跳舞歌唱，他沉浸在他，而且他对于其他受苦的、受条件限制的灵魂充满怜悯。
So actually, Prahlad pleased all kinds of people.
实际上 Prahlad 取悦了各种各样的人。
But Prahlad Maharaj himself, he's saying that these are not signs of a great personality. These are not signs of a person engaged in devotional service. It's not a sign,
但是,
not a sign that somebody's actually advanced in devotion.
但是 Prahlad 本人却说, 这些并不是一个在灵性, 奉爱服务当中, 高度进步的人士的一个迹象。Because
Narada Muni, he'd been saying that Prahlad had been a great devotee of the Lord since his childhood. But Prahlad is saying, no, it's not true. He said, I was just doing these things by the mercy of my spiritual master. Told me to do these things, but actually, I'm not a great devotee.
那的赞美，Prahlad是从小孩提时代时候救世主的伟大奉献者，但是Prahlad却否矢口否认。他说：“我之所以这么做呢，只是由于我的灵性导师的命令而已。”So
Prahlad is denying some of the things which Narada claims show that he's a great devotee.
普拉德便矢口否认，Narada称呼，声称他是一个伟大的奉献者，他对此矢口否认。Yeah,
some things he denies, and other things he just sees them in a different way.
有些话呢，他就否认，还有一些，他是以一种不同的角度来看待。So
Prahlad says, because I was a child, I couldn't have pure devotion. Because I wasn't mature.
Prahlad 说，因为我当时还是一个小孩子，所以我不可能是成熟的。Yeah,
a child doesn't have the strength to understand things and to do things properly.
因为孩子们他们是没有理解力的，他们也不能正确的采取正确的行为。
He was able to understand the difficult things which his father Hiranyakashipu did to him, but he could understand them only because of the protection given by all the devotees.
就是对他施以了暴行，但是他说他之所以能够承受呢，只是由于主，由于奉献，由于主的保护。Yeah,
only because of the devotee's mercy he was able to put up with all the troubles which his father put on him.
只是由于主对于奉献者的仁慈，他才可以
And he got protected by the internal potency of the Lord. And Prahlad says, he said, I know also some demons became Vaishnavas due to Prahlad's preaching. He said, yeah, I made some demons into devotees.
Prahlad 承认说，确实。
But Prahlad says, I was preaching to them only because really great souls are not supposed to instruct immature children.
Prahlad 说，我之所以向这些小孩子们传教。 理由是那些真正伟大的灵魂是不会向那些不成熟的孩子们来教导他们的。And
Prahlad said, in any case, you know, words are cheap. It's easy to talk.
而且 Prahlad 呢又说到，言语它是廉价的，就说一说是很容易的事情。
It's easy enough for anyone to make himself sound like an expert, but when it comes to advising others, it's not so easy. When he's advising others, it's easy enough to sound like you're expert, but it doesn't mean you're actually expert.
当给别人提建议的时候呢，让自己听上去像个专家。这是非常容易的事情，但这并不意味他真正就变成了专家了。
So Prahlad doesn't even mention how Narada had described him as being fully absorbed in meditation on Krishna.
Prahlad 甚至没有提到 Narada 描述他完全沉浸于在冥想 Krishna。
Prahlad Maharaj considers it would be too embarrassing to admit anything like that openly.
Prahlad 认为公开的承认这一点是太令人难堪了。
But Prahlad does admit that he was dancing and singing in ecstasy.
Prahlad 但是 Prahlad 承认他在狂喜当中，他唱歌跳舞。
But even neophytes, very new devotees, they can also show these things. These are just external symptoms.
但即便是一个新人也可以展示出这些外在的征候。
People who are new devotees, who are beginners, they should also dance and sing as a matter of duty.
一个初习者也应当作为职责，他们也应当来唱歌跳舞。
So Narada was offering, he was describing so many symptoms of Prahlad to show him as a great devotee, but Prahlad was not, he would not, he did not agree that these are signs of a great devotee.
所以 Narada 呢，他就是描述。Prahlad 的种种的迹象来赞扬他是一个伟大的奉献者，但是 Prahlad 并不承认他是伟大的奉献者。
Yeah, Prahlad is just a sign of natural devotional service, pure devotional service. That you do these things, you sing and dance. Everyone does it.
Prahlad 呢说，任何人他从事纯粹的奉爱服务的话，他都会展示出这样的迹象。
So when we become pure devotees, when our intelligence becomes mature, and that happens only when we get good instructions from the spiritual teachers.
当一个人智慧变得成熟之后呢，他会得到灵性导师的训示。
So Prahlad Maharaj said, "The things I was doing, my behavior." That is no reason to make me into a great devotee.
Prahlad 就争辩说，他的这些行为并不就代表着他就是一个伟大的奉献者。
The people who should actually get the credit are Lord Nrisingadev and Narada Muni. They're the ones who should get the credit.
功劳应该归功于 Narada Muni 和主 Nrisingadev。
So from these symptoms, don't think that Krishna has given a person his mercy.
仅仅从这些征兆迹象来迹象，就不要断定就是 Krishna 已经给了人他的仁慈了。
Krishna's mercy appears only in a truly worthy servant.
Krishna 的仁慈只会给予一个真正配得到这样的仁慈的仆人。
The most advanced saints are pure devotees who understand the power of devotional service to Lord Krishna.
真正进步的圣人们是那些纯粹的奉献者，他们能够理解对圣主 Krishna 莲花族的奉爱服务的威力。
And Prahlad Maharaj said, I could not have received Krishna's special mercy because he gives that only to a devotee who deserves it.
Prahlad 说, 我不可能获得 Krishna 的特殊仁慈，因为他只会把这些仁慈给予一个值得、配得到这样的仁慈的奉献者。
And Prahlad says that you Narada Muni, you are blessed by the Lord's internal potency. You've received His mercy.
Prahlad 就反驳说。您拿着的木棉，您才是得到了主的内在能量的赐福，您得到了他的仁慈。
You know that only a proper person can receive Krishna's mercy.
您深知，只有一个恰当的候选人才能得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
And the mercy of Krishna is beyond the limits of time and space.
Krishna 的仁慈，它超越了时空的限制。
But it becomes visible only at certain times in certain suitable devotees.
但是在物质世界，它只是在一个特定的时间，在特定的奉献者身上才能看到。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好的，我们今天早上的正课就讲到这里。
Other questions today?
我们来看一下问题。Yes, there are quite some questions. 第一个是来自于 Padma Mupi， 不是 ，sorry， 这是 Padma Mupi 转发。Yeah，
我来读吧。
Okay.
就是上周四的问题。顶拜工作队，顶拜翻译，有人问，没有取悦奉献者是不是一种冒犯？他应该怎么做？
Yeah. Yes. If we don't please devotees, it's an offense.
是的，如果没有取悦奉献者，就是做了冒犯了。
We should always think how to please Krishna and Krishna's devotees.
我们应当总是把取悦 Krishna 和取悦 Krishna 的奉献者放在心中。
So how to please them? Well, you have to speak nice words and be pleasing to them and speak words which are they like to hear.
那该如何取悦他们呢？你得说好听的话。就是你得让他们感到愉悦，就是您的话呢得动听。
You should be happy to meet the devotees.
见到奉献者应该兴高采烈。
When we meet the devotees, we should smile and we should be pleased. We should think, I'm so fortunate to meet the devotee.
见到奉献者的时候，应该脸上展开笑逐颜开，然后呢，特别的心情开朗愉快，而且表达说：“哎呀，我是太幸运了，我能遇见您。”
Okay.
这个是周一的问题，哈利尼。顶拜咕噜队，请问怎么做才能使自己更纯净，以及清除？我遵守四项原则外，做什么样的事，还是罪恶的活动？Guru Mani,
yeah. So how can I make myself more purified, except for regular principles? What others are considered sinful activities, except for sin principle?
Well, if we offend the devotees, then that's very bad for us.
冒犯奉献者就对我们特别糟糕。
If we criticize them, speak bad words about the devotees.
批评奉献者，说他们的坏话。
So we should always try to praise the devotees and appreciate them.
所以我们应当努力地去赞美奉献者，取悦奉献者。
So we want to be very careful to deal with the devotees in a manner which is pleasing to them.
所以我们的对待奉献者呢，要很小心。我们的行为举止呢，要令奉献者感到开心愉悦。
Yeah, the devotees are representatives of Krishna, so we have to deal nicely with them.
奉献者们是 Krishna 的代表，因此我们应该跟他们交往的时候，应该对他们非常好。So
sometimes it means offering prasadam or accepting prasadam, or giving a gift or accepting a gift, or inquiring confidentially. Or revealing your mind in confidence.
就跟奉献之间进行六项的爱心交流，接受 prasadam， 给予 prasadam， 接受礼物， 给予礼物， 向他们机密的询问， 以及， 袒露自己的心声。
Okay. Yeah.
这个是 Sruti Rupa。 Hare Krishna, Divine Guru Dev, 我们身边有一年多的信人，最近回到了以前佛法团队，去跟随一个观音菩萨的化身的师父，说那里求什么都很灵，而休息 Krishna 知觉实在太苦了。请问 Guru Dev， 我们还有必要去劝他回来？ 这样的新人呢，还是更加提升我们自己灵性知识和进步呢？这是第一个问题，Guru Maharaj。Shruti
Rupa Maharaji, said that, dear Gurudev, there is one new devotee who associated with us for more than 1 year, recently. This new devotee returned to the former Buddhist group and to follow our incarnation of Guanyin. This new devotee said that it's very. Whatever he desires, she desires, she can fulfill her desire very quickly. And to practice Krishna consciousness is so austere. So my question is that, Guru, is it necessary for us to persuade this person to go back or to let it go and to elevate ourselves, our Krishna consciousness?
Well, you have to consider how much the person is likely to come back. Do you really think you have the ability to convince them to come back?
您自己得权衡和考虑一下，就这个人有没有可能再回来？ 还有一个，您自己真的有那个能力能说动他回来吗？
And you have to consider how much serious they were when they were in Krishna consciousness. Were they genuinely practicing?
而且他们当初呢，在 Krishna 知觉当中的时候，他是不是怀着一颗真诚的心在修炼？
But you. The person left, they said, oh, Krishna consciousness is very austere. I don't know, where is the austerity? What were they doing which was so austere? I don't know.
就这个离开的人，他说 Krishna 知觉太苦了，那到底苦在哪里呢？不知道，苦在哪里。
第二个吗？
Yeah, people think if they think Krishna consciousness is very austere, then yeah, it will be difficult for them to come back. If they think it was so hard to be a devotee, it would be very difficult to bring them back. Usually, I don't know what was the difficulty. What was so difficult for them?
心回意转是挺难的，如果他们认为当奉献者太困难了，嗯，所以说不知道他觉得难在哪里。
OK。
啊，第二个问题，请问咕噜队，是否做任何事情之前，都可以先念诵咕噜队和圣帕布帕德的祷文？嗯。祈求仁慈后，把一切与灵性结合起来呢？可以并且带着这种知觉，训练自己每天都是生命的最后一天吗？感恩，亲爱的咕噜队。
The second part of the question is that should we before doing everything, we should recite the pranam mantra of Guru and Srila Prabhupada and beg their mercy, and after that to make everything we do to connect with the spirit, to make it spiritualized, and with this kind of consciousness train ourselves and tell us that maybe this is the final day in our life.
Well, yeah, you can think like that.
可以，您可以这样，有带着这种想法。
Yeah, we don't know when we have to leave the world. Maybe we can think any moment we may have to leave the world. We should be ready to die.
我们也不知道我们哪天离开这世界，也许是随时都可以，可能离开，所以我们要提前做好准备。
So we should be ready to give up everything and to just fix our mind on Krishna.
我们应该准备好放弃一切，将心意专注于 Krishna.
Yeah.
下一个是 Yuvati Sachi. Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. If a person does not want to develop bhakti and love for Krishna, but at the same time he observes the rules, will there be any result from his sadhana? For example, he likes to associate with devotees. He is interested in reading books, but he is not interested in bhakti.
Well, yeah, he'll get some benefit. He's not interested in bhakti, he just reads the books.And he follows the principles, okay, he gets some benefit. We don't know how long he can keep reading the books. We don't know how long he can keep following the principles. If he doesn't practice bhakti, then it may not be for very long. If he's not, he may read the books for a little while, and then he reads other books. And he may follow the principles for some time, but then he doesn't really care. So he doesn't have any bhakti, he doesn't chant, so he doesn't make any real spiritual progress. But he doesn't do anything sinful, so he's materially pious, but not devotee.
Hare Krishna, Guru Mani, 你没有念中文。
哦、sorry, 我来翻译一下。Yuvati Sachi 的问题是Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有荣耀归于 Srila Prabhupada。倘若一个人他不想发展出奉爱之情，对 Krishna 的奉爱，但是同时呢，他又遵守规则， 他的 sadhana 他有没有会得到任何好处？比如说，他喜欢跟外面的联谊，也对读书感兴趣，但他就是对于奉爱不感兴趣。这个马上回答是，就是他也会从中得到好处，他读书啊，对他来说是没问题的，但是他也遵守原则，他不修习奉爱。但是，就是问题在于他能持续多久？他可能读一段时间的书，或者是遵守一段时间的原则，但是他内心并不是真正的在乎这件事儿。他也，因为他并不念诵，所以他不会取得真实实在在的进步。但是他没有从事罪恶活动，所以在物质的角度来说，这样的人也算虔诚的人，但是他不能算作是奉献者。
下一个这个没有名字，清除嫉妒需要多长时间？发现自己有嫉妒之心，怎么办好？
How long does it take to eliminate enviness? I found myself have envy in my heart. What to do?
Well, it can take a long time and it can take a moment. It's up to you. How serious are you to remove the envy from your heart?
这可能会花很长一段时间，也可能片刻就能去除，这取决于。您的真诚的态度，您的努力到底有多么真诚？
Envy is the state of mind that you think somebody has something which you don't. Someone has something more than you. You're envious of them.
嫉妒它是一种心理状态，心意的状态。你认为，某人他拥有的事物你没有，然后他比你拥有的更多。所以你就产生了嫉妒，心怀嫉妒。
So if we cultivate transcendental knowledge, if you actually cultivate good knowledge and understand spiritual knowledge, then you'll give up that envy.
倘若你培养了超然的知识，你培养出灵性的理解力的话呢，就能放弃这种嫉妒。
Just like we may envy someone or someone he's very They're very good looking, and I'm not so good looking. So we will envy them that, oh, they're so attractive, and I'm not so attractive. But if you have transcendental knowledge, you'll remember, you can think that in the last life, I was good looking, and they were not good looking. Now the situation is reversed.
比如说吧，一个人他的相貌特别的美丽英俊。然后特别有吸引力，我们就嫉妒了，说就觉得这个人长得那么漂亮，而我长相貌不那么好看。但如果你有超然理解力的话，您就会明白，那在上一世呢，我也是相貌堂堂的，英俊潇洒的。然后这个人呢，上一世呢，他不一定长得那么好看。
So transcendental knowledge is very important. We have to control the mind and not allow ourselves to envy. We have to understand that the material world is a very temporary. Every situation we're in is very temporary. It's not eternal.
所以在这一世呢，都颠倒过来了。倘若我们有超然的知识，我们应该控制心意，不要嫉妒。我们要明白呢。物质世界一切都是短暂的，所有的处境呢，也都是昙花一现。
Someone may be very rich and we're not so rich, but in the previous life we were rich and they were not rich.
有人呢，这一世呢，可能假富一方，而我们却一贫如洗，没有钱。但是可能我们上一世呢，是特别的富有的，而那个人呢，可能上一世没有什么钱财。
So. The envy is all based on the bodily conception of life. We're thinking, I am the body.
这个嫉妒都是产生于躯体化的生命概念。我们因为我们认同于我就是这个身体。
So So you have to come to the higher platform. You have to raise your consciousness to the spiritual platform.
所以你要提升自己的知觉，到达灵性的层面上，到更高的层面。
All right. Yes.
下一个问题是文燕的，Hare Krishna 顶拜咕噜队的莲花族，顶拜甜美的翻译，咕噜队讲到 ，Krishna 只会给人 ，Krishna 只会把仁慈给特定的人，那么奉献者们经常说 ，Krishna 给的仁慈，经常这么说，恰当吗 ？Hare Krishna。
Proper. Yeah. Krishna gives mercy. Yeah.
Because in the lecture, Prahlad Maharaj denied saying that Krishna only give mercy to special devotee. But we often hear devotees say that this is the mercy from Krishna. Is it proper for us to say like that?
Yes. Yes, it's proper. Yeah. A devotee always gives the credit to Krishna and Guru.
是的，这样说是恰当的。一个奉献者呢，等着把功劳归功于 Krishna.
The question is, what is mercy?
那现在问题就是，什么是仁慈？
You know, Krishna gave this. Is it mercy?
Krishna 给了我这个，这是仁慈。
It's mercy when we use it properly for the service of Krishna.
我们把 Krishna 给我们的正确的用于为 Krishna 服务的话，那么这就是仁慈。Krishna
may give you money, and so the money is Krishna's mercy if you use it for Krishna's service.
Krishna 给了你钱财，倘若你把钱财用来服务 Krishna。 那么这就属于是 Krishna 的仁慈。
Krishna didn't give you money just for your sense gratification.
Krishna 给了你钱，不是为了让你拿去挥霍，用来感官享乐。下一个，这个有一个是，这有一个是 Sambhog 给我发的。我先读一下那个。 Sambhoga 说：“Guru好，我总是冥想，看到自己的灵魂在体内是一半，而观其他人都是完整的。请问Guru这现象怎么解释？”Sambhoga Maharaj said that Guru, when I meditate, in my meditation, I saw myself, my soul in my body is only a half, and in my meditation I saw the others are complete. So how to explain the phenomenon?
What do you mean the soul is only half? How is it possible?
您说您观想自己的灵魂在体内是一半的，是什么意思？这个是怎么可能？
The soul cannot be cut, it cannot be divided, it's eternal.
灵魂不可被分割，不可被割裂，灵魂是永恒，永恒存在的。
How can you say your soul is only half?
那您怎么可以断定自己的灵魂是一半呢？
You should be chanting Hare Krishna, you should not be meditating.
您应该唱诵 Hare Krishna， 您不应该就是在那里观想。You
chant Hare Krishna and associate with Krishna through His holy name.
您唱诵 Hare Krishna， 通过 Krishna 的圣名和 Krishna 联谊。Your
soul is complete. You're a complete soul, and Krishna is complete also. Krishna's in your heart.
您的灵魂是完整的。 而 Krishna 也是完整的 ，Krishna 就在您的内心。
Okay.
下一个是 Suki Data Mataji， 请问不是顶拜感恩咕噜马哈扎贾精彩的讲课，感恩咕噜玛尼的翻译，请问上周您解答的奉献者问题时说月经期可以提前把可以提前做好准备，提前供奉月经就是已经供奉过的菩萨的，那么一周的食物都提前做出来吗？对于居士家庭崇拜仪一定要这样做吗？家人吃一星期的冰箱食物肯定非常愤怒，是否可以在月经期沐浴净身，换上干净的衣服，做饭给主供奉？感恩解答疑惑。Good morning.
This question is related to the nectar of devotion. When you answer the question, that when a woman in her menstruation, she should prepare in advance to cook food in advance and offer. And during that period of time, we should eat offered prasad. But that for the whole week, is that we should prepare the food in advance for a whole week? For Grihastha family, is it necessary for the Grihastha to do that worship, to do that? Because for the family members, for the whole week, to eat food, frozen food in the refrigerator, they must be very angry, their mind. Is that okay that during the menstrual period, we bathe and we put on clean dress and we cook prasad and offer the food for the Lord? Thank you.
Yes. Well, usually the system is that when the woman is in the period of menstruation, at that time, the man will cook rather than the lady will cook. The service would go to another, to the man, because the woman considers, one thing is that during menstruation, she doesn't feel so strong, she feels weak, and so she needs to rest. And so at that time, it's proper usually for the man to go and cook and do the cooking.
一般来说呢，就是传统上或者说这个制度是这样的，就是在女性的经期期间呢，这个服务就转到了男人身上了，然后由男人来做服务，来去做菩萨的，这是比较恰当的，因为女性在经期期间呢。她是比较脆弱的，她不那么强壮身体，她是这段期间呢，实际上她是需要休息的，所以这个一般呢就是干活，这些活服务就转到男人身上了。
And the menstruation cycle doesn't last for a week, it just lasts like two or maximum 3 days and it's over with, and so just for a couple of days like that.
而且这个经期它也 maybe for some women it will last a week.
Really?
Yeah, yes.
Oh.
If yes, for some women it's a
okay, different for different ladies. For some ladies, you know, it's going to last longer. Yeah.
反正就对于不同的女性呢，她可能经期时间长度不一样，有的可能很短，两三天结束了，有的可能长一点。
So the idea is that you know if there's nobody else there to cook, And if you're serving the deity, usually, I mean, Prabhupada allowed it in the beginning. He allowed it because in the beginning there were no, you know, there were no men, and there was not enough men to do everything. So the ladies would just do it. They'd go into the kitchen and cook, even though they were contaminated. But we should just understand that that's not the highest level of worship. So we have to understand what we're capable of doing. Everything is according to time and circumstances. So if you're not able to do things like that, then you have to adjust, you know. And if your husband doesn't mind cooking, eating food when you're contaminated, then it's not a problem. But sometimes, you know, in Hindu society at least, you know, the people, they're very particular about this. And they think if the woman is contaminated, that, oh, she shouldn't be cooking, and they won't want to eat her food. Some people are like that. They won't want to eat the food because it's cooked by a woman during her menstruation cycle. But if the husband doesn't mind to eat the food like that, then it's not a problem. Then you, okay, go ahead and do it. But just, you know, the problem comes that if you put the deity, and you want to offer things to the deity. And so you have to ask Krishna, you have to tell Krishna, you know, I'm sorry, Krishna, I'm in this situation, and I'm cooking, although I'm contaminated. So, you know, either if you want, you can accept it. If you don't want, anyway, I'm offering it to you. If you don't want to accept it, I'm sorry.
<笑>就是一开始呢，Prabhupada是允许，就庙里没有足够的男性奉献者的时候，Prabhupada也允许女性奉献者在经期呢下厨房。 但是这不是一个，因为当时没有那么多的人为神像做饭，但这要明白呢，这不是一个很高层面的。后来就不是了，就是要根据你的能力，根据时间啊、环境，如果你就是做不到的话呢，你就得调整。但如果你的丈夫不在乎吃污染的食物，那就无所谓了。因为按照就是印度的社团，他们就特别挑剔。 他们认为就是处于一个污染期，他们就会不吃女性在污染期所做的任何食物。但如果你丈夫不在乎，那你就去做呗。就问题就在于，如果是神像的话，服务了神像，你就得问 Krishna， 你得告诉 Krishna，向 Krishna 陈述一下，说对不起啊 ，Krishna， 我现在处于污染期，然后你把食物供奉在那里。 然后你跟 Krishna 说 ，Krishna， 如果你想接受，你就接受；如果你不想接受，那对不起，我也没有办法，就是看 Krishna 自己来决定了。
Mm-hmm. We have to understand, you know, at home you're not going to be able to do things on the same standard we do them in the temple. Now, in the temple, of course, when a woman is, but as I said, even in the beginning of our movement, when women were contaminated, still they would cook.
要明白的一点是，就是家中的标准和庙里的标准，它是两个标准。但是呢，就刚Guru也说过，就在我们的运动的一开始的时候呢，Prabhupada也是允许，就是女性在这个污染期做饭了。So
gradually, you know, they introduced these things into the temple. They brought things to a higher standard because they were becoming more familiar with the scriptures and what the scriptures say, and they wanted to follow the scriptures, so they would arrange to do it.
逐渐的呢，就是庙里的崇拜呢，也标准越来越高。就是当奉献者熟悉了经典呢，并且遵守经典，按照经典去做的话，他们就会这样去安排。
You know, we're not saying you have to do this, but you know, but we just want you to know what's the standard, there is a standard. So you have to consider your situation. Of course, you have a family or you have a husband, and if he doesn't cook, then you should cook for him, even though you're contaminated. And if he doesn't mind, then yeah, go ahead, cook for him.
Mm. 所以我们就是，这并不是说，你必须得这么做，强制性的不是这样的。你就需要知道这个标准，要知道标准是什么标准，然后呢，你就酌情考虑您自己的情况。如果您的家庭，您的丈夫不做饭，那么他也不在乎你在污染期所做的食物，那你就去做了。
Yeah. You have to cook, yeah.You have a family, you have to cook. Whether you're, if nobody else is there to cook, then you have to do it. Even if you're contaminated, you still have to do it. Okay.
下一个问题是柴坦亚查朗。哈利·克里什纳顶拜咕噜的，感谢翻译。有人说玛雅瓦蒂到不了梵光，到梵光的是另一种非人格主义者。是这样的吗？
Yes, usually, yeah. Impersonalists go into the Brahma Jyoti.
Some, Chaitanya Charanprabhu said that someone says, Mayavadi cannot go to the Brahma Jyoti. The people who go to Brahma Jyoti is another kind of impersonalist.
Yeah. The Mayavadi is an offender to Krishna.
是的。就是假象宗是 Krishna 的冒犯者。
But there are impersonalists called Brahmagyanis. Brahmagyanis, they're not offenders to Krishna, but they worship, they just go to the, their goal is just to go to the impersonal Brahman. So they can go to the, into the impersonal Brahman.
但是有一类非超然主义者叫 Brahmagyani, 他们是非人格主义者，他们没有对 Krishna 做出冒犯，他们可以去非人格的梵光。
The Mayavadi, he says Krishna has a material form, but the Brahmagyanis, they don't say any, they don't criticize, they don't say anything about Krishna. They just simply concentrate on the impersonal Brahman.
假象宗人士认为，他们说 Krishna 有个物质的形象， Krishna 的形体是物质的，但是 Brahmagyani 他们不批评 Krishna， 他们也不说，他们说的话都不涉及 Krishna， 他们只是专心的一心一意的想着非人格的梵光。
下一个吗？下一个是张明，顶拜咕噜。请接受我谦卑的顶拜，一切荣耀归于帕布帕德。请问读报纸，电子书、视频这些传媒，这些传媒界本身是否分别属于不同属性，善良、激情、愚昧，还是主要取决于他们传达的内容呢？哈利·克里什纳。
Zhang Ming said that, obeisant guru, my question is that, reading books and electric books and video, such media, is this belong to,the different category, like in the mood of goodness, passion, and ignorance, or is it depend to the content?
Yes, it will depend on the content.
是取决于他们要传达的内容。
Just like we also use e-books, we are also using e-books.We're using, but it depends how you use everything. If you use it for the service of Krishna, then that is transcendental.
We also have 电子书 就是这是取决于我们对这些现代科技的用法。如果是将它们用于服务 Krishna， 那么它们就是超然的。
Videos can also be used to broadcast the message of Krishna consciousness. So that's all right. That's transcendental. But if you're if your video is mundane, then of course it will be influenced by the modes of nature.
就是这个视频呢，如果传递的是 Krishna 知觉的讯息的话，是可以的，是超然的。但如果传递的是世俗的讯息，那么它势必就受到物质自然三属性的影响。
下一个还是柴参加查当顶拜咕噜对。有人说嫉妒不能用来做妨碍服务，有人说嫉妒可以用来做妨碍服务。想跟咕噜对确认一下，嫉妒是否用来做妨碍服务？如果能，应该怎样应用？
Somebody is envious, can they do devotional service or not?
Somebody says that the enviness cannot be used for devotional service. Some says yes, we can. I want to confirm that whether or not we can use the mentality of enviness for devotional service. If we can, then how to apply it?
Well, generally envy is not used in devotional service. Lord Krishna glorifies Arjuna that he is not envious of Krishna. And that's why Krishna speaks the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna.
一般而言，嫉妒是不可以用来做奉献服务的。Krishna 荣耀了 Arjuna， 说 Arjuna 是不嫉妒 Krishna。正是因为这个原因，这部《薄伽梵歌》才被讲述给 Arjuna。
Similarly, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it states in the second verse of the first canto, first chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, that this Srimad Bhagavatam is for those who are not envious.
同样，在《圣典薄伽瓦坛》第一篇第一章是第二个世节就说到，这部《圣典薄伽瓦坛》是给那些不怀嫉妒的人讲述的。
Dharma projita kaitavo traparamo nirmatsaranam satam. So nirmatsaranam satam means those who are without any envy. So when people give up envy, then they can properly understand Srimad Bhagavatam, the teachings of Krishna.
就刚才Guru 讲的这个师节的意思，就是说这部圣典薄伽瓦坛是给那些没有嫉妒之心的。放弃了嫉妒的人们，他们放弃了嫉妒，才能够理解 Krishna 的教导。
Okay, yeah. So envy, we see people like Sishupal was very envious of Krishna. Ultimately, there's a demonic quality to be envious of Krishna.
我们看到呢。在施舒帕勒的例子当中呢，他对 Krishna 始终怀着嫉妒，这个嫉妒它是恶魔品质。
So that envy is quality in the material world. It's not really useful. It's not in our devotional service.
这个物质世界的这种品性，我们通常不会用它来。应用到我们的奉爱服务当中。
Now someone may have more than us, we should understand that they've been somehow they've received some special blessings from Krishna, some the arrangement of Krishna that they're having something which we don't. We should appreciate that this is, you know, this is given to them as a result, maybe the results of their past activities.Or it may be by the arrangement of Krishna.
倘若有的人呢，他们拥有的比我们超过了我们的话，那我们应该明白呢， 他们是得到了Krishna 特殊的祝福，Krishna 的安排。由于 Krishna 的特殊祝福，然后他们有了我没有的，所以我们应该欣赏他们。我们应该明白呢，或者这是由于他们过往的活动导致的，或者是由于 Krishna 的安排。
If someone's not a devotee, but you envy them, you should, they have something more. We should understand that's the workings of the law of karma. They have more by the laws of karma. Due to some past pious activity, they've been given some better facilities.
如果这个就是拥有的很多的超过我们的人，他是不是奉献者？就是那我们应该明白呢，就是他所拥有的是由于他的 karma， 他的果报工作，过去的前程活动导致他现在有这么好的条件，物质条件。
But for someone who's a devotee, we should think that this is the arrangement of Krishna, that Krishna has given them facilities.For their service to him.
如果是一个奉献者的话呢，我们应该明白呢，这是 Krishna 所做出的安排。Krishna 就安排他有了这样的条件，好让他呢能够为Krishna 本人做出服务。
Okay, yeah. Padmamukhi, 还有问题吗？
还有的，这个还是那个灵性导师平等对待每一个门徒吗？平等赐予每一个门徒的仁慈吗？看起来不是平等赐予门徒仁慈。这种想法说明什么？这种想法正确吗？咕噜妈咪
，This person is asking that. Is the spiritual master.Deals equally with every disciple, and give equal mercy to disciple. If one thinks that the spiritual master thinks not give the equal mercy to every devotee, what does if someone has that kind of thinking, what does mean? Well, is it proper?
It may be proper. Maybe someone is in need of extra attention or special attention from the spiritual teacher.
就因为灵性，so the spiritual master does give some disciple extra mercy.
Yeah, he may do. Yeah.
Okay. 灵性导师可以给有的门徒特殊的仁慈，因为这个门徒呢，他需要更多的关注，或者他需要的仁慈更多。
Yeah, the spiritual teacher has to consider every individual how much they're able to engage. That if he can engage someone more in Krishna's service.Then certainly he will give them more mercy.
这灵性导师他要考虑，他就是让这些门徒从事于奉献服务，如果他需要这个门徒从事更多的奉献服务，他肯定会给他更多的仁慈。
Somebody wants to do some service, then the spiritual master will encourage them.
有的人他就想做服务，所以灵性导师就会鼓励他们。
And some devotees they don't want to do service, they just want to stay away. So what? How can the spiritual master give mercy?
有的奉献者他就不想做服务，他就想躲开。那灵性导师又怎么能给他仁慈呢
？If they don't come near to the spiritual master, they don't approach the spiritual master, then it's difficult for the spiritual master to give them mercy.
倘若就是他不想接近灵性导师，灵性导师也很难给他仁慈。
So you want to get the mercy of the spiritual master, you have to come to be with the spiritual master and come to inquire from the spiritual master and associate and get connected.
如果你想得到您想得到仁慈的话，您就要来和领导在一起，向领导师做出询问，和领导联谊，和领导师连接在一起。
下一个还是柴塔尼亚查当第三个问题，顶拜古鲁队，国家梵歌第九章15世节讲崇拜。
不是，他上面还说发现自己有嫉妒之心，怎么办？那个我都读了，你给漏掉了吧？sorry. So the final part of the question is that I found myself to have the emptiness. What to do?
Well, we should work on it by cultivating transcendental knowledge and purify your heart by devotional service. Do more intense hearing and chanting.
我们需要培养超人的知识，净化内心，在服务奉献服务当中，净化内心，做更强烈的聆听和唱诵，来净化掉嫉妒之心。
And train your mind to see good, not to be envious.
然后一定要看别人的优点和长处，不要心怀嫉妒。然后，柴塔尼亚查当第三个问题，顶拜古鲁，博伽梵歌第九章15世节讲崇拜主的三类人。然后16世节开始，窥视大师说：“我就是伟大一世，一直到19世节，这之间有什么联系？” 感恩，不是感觉接不上，可以讲一下这里面的连接呀。
Chaitanya Prabhu is asking you to explain the connection between Bhagavad Gita 9:15, in which explain the three type of person who worship Lord, and then from Verse 16, Lord Krishna said, I'm the Vedic separate Vedic rituals. Until verse 19, what's the relationship between verse 15? I feel there's no distinct connection. Can you explain?
Verse 16 to 19?
Yes, verse 16 to 19, the connection with verse 15.
Verse 16 to 19, they're describing the worship of the universal form.
第16世节到第19世节在描述着主的宇宙形象。
Lord Krishna described three kinds of people, different kinds of devotees. They're worshipping Krishna in different way. In verse 15, he describes there are others who worship. So some people worship the universal form, and some people worship demigods, and some people worship the impersonal feature.
在第15世节当中，主 Krishna
就描述说，有的人崇拜他的宇宙形象，还有些人崇拜半神，还有人崇拜他的非人格特征。下一个是Rajendra，感谢亲爱的Guru Maharaja。 感谢尊敬的翻译。一般来讲，分离痛苦，在灵修初级阶段无法体验Gopi-Kida中的净化、极乐和爱，是否推存在初级阶段学唱？
Rajendra's question is that can we recommend the new devotees to learn to sing Gopi Gita?
No.
不推荐他们学。
Go ahead.
下一个，下一个，
Suruki Rata， 家里有男人，不是奉献者，而且吃肉的，可以给主做，可以给主做饭供奉吗？比如经济，比如经济的奉献者给主供奉更好吗？男人坚决不下厨房怎么办？孩子上学也不能天天吃剩的，也不能天天吃剩饭，是不是可以经期就不吃菩萨的吗？或者心意供奉就行了？三个问题。
Sumiki rather is continued question. She said that the husband is not a devotee and not a vegetarian. Can she cook for the Lord and offer?
What, cook meat and offer?
No. Can he cook food and after that offered?Cook.
Well, in your home, you can do these things. Yes.
那在您的家中可以的。
In your home, you set the standards which you want to follow.
在您的家是您说了算，标准是您定的，然后您就遵守这个标准。
Yes.
Is it better for a woman devotee who is in her man's strength to cook for the Lord? Which is better?
Well, better is the husband cooks.
那最好还是丈夫做饭更好。
And you rest.
然后您就休息吧。She said if the husband insisted not to cook, what to do? Because the children has to go to school. And
then you have to cook.
She said, can she cook an offer in the mine?
Yeah. You can offer. You can offer, but on the altar, you don't have to offer in your mind. You can offer, but do it like I told you, that I'm sorry, I'm contaminated, but there's nobody else to cook.
就是刚才各位说了，就是您可以到神坛上供奉这些做好的食物，您然后跟主要那个说一下，说对不起，就是也没人做饭，然后这个就是我做的，因为虽然我现在处于这个污染期，但是对不起家人，也没人做饭，您得跟主说一下。
OK，
好，这个可以了。那个下一个是妙音。我谦卑地顶拜工作队，顶拜翻译。我脱壁快一年了。
怎么看的是天使在唱歌？您看的跟我不一样吗？
没有，我这没有那个天使。
你少了是吗？我这有一个天使在唱歌。他说：“顶拜孤乳，我们爱上了一个人，是因为我们的业报命中注定，还是因为涟漪导致的？对一个非奉献者有强烈的喜欢和依恋。”如何放下并净化这一物质层面的感情？ She said, we love a person. Is it due to our destiny or due to the association? Because I have a strong attachment and I like a non-devotee. How can I give up the feeling and purify myself and add?Purified the material feeling.
Yes. So you have to change your, you have to find another, find a devotee to love.
您得找一个奉献者去爱这个奉献者。
You have to find, or at least somebody who is favorable, or who can allow you to practice Krishna consciousness.
至少您要找一个就是对 Krishna 直觉有好感， 支持赞同的，并且允许您修习 Krishna 之觉的人。
It's woman's nature. She wants to love and be loved. She wants a companion. So, you have to find a suitable companion who can also allow you to practice Krishna consciousness.
女性的天性就是去爱和被爱，并且有一个伴侣，所以您应该找一个就是能够合适的伴侣，允许您修习 Krishna 之觉的伴侣。下一个我这里看到的是啊，家里是要和啊，已经回答了这个Sumiti Radha 的问题，不是庙里，家里和庙里一样严格，就是刚才已经回答了。那您读吧 ，Sumiti Radha 妙音是吧？
对，妙音。我谦卑的顶拜咕噜队，顶拜翻译。他脱贫已经快一年了，每天都念诵规定的圈数，聆听朗读经典。吃供奉的菩萨的，他想启迪，可以吗？如果他要该做些什么？还是可以呢
？You have to get recommendation from somebody, some authorized person. They have to recommend you. The first thing is you have to take the ISKCON disciple course, and then the ISKCON disciple course they will teach you the process of initiation.
您需要得到一个权威人士的推荐，并且呢您首先要去参加门徒课程，在门徒课程当中就教了启迪的程序。The next one、
他好像是门徒课程已经上完了。
So then you should know the process.How to get initiation. You don't need to ask me, you should know it. And in the disciple course, they taught it. First, you have to take shelter, and you take shelter when you're by being recommended by a qualified person.
那您就是需要，就是您，他说他已经脱壁了。She said she had already taken shelter for nearly almost 1 year.那您就是在，因为您上了门徒课程，就您需要得。
So somebody else has to recommend.
Sorry. 是这样的，就是如果您已经都万事俱备，只欠东风，您就找一个推荐人就好了。
那好的。下一个问题，这个名字我叫不上来。哈利奎什纳顶拜咕噜和翻译的莲花族，多次听灵性导师与资深奉献者说，如果奎什纳对你笑一次，你的生命便成功了。请问这是否包括神像的笑？怎么来理解这句话？你便成功了，是否只要昆士纳的神像形体笑一次，一生便可以重返灵性世界吗？这是代表，这代表着纯粹奉献服务开始。非常感恩咕噜解答疑惑。
She is asking that.I often heard the spiritual master and senior devotees said, if Krishna has ever smiled to you even once, then your life is successful. So does that smile, including the smile from the deities, how to understand? So does that mean that if Krishna's deity form smile to you, to us even once, then...In this very lifetime, we can return back to the spiritual world? Or does that mean that it is the beginning of the pure devotional service? Thank you.
Generally, we would think it's the beginning of pure devotional service.
一般呢， 我们认为这个是纯粹奉爱服的开端。下一个。
下一个是柴塔尼亚，柴塔尼亚如法，尊敬的 Guru Dev，我们中国东北马杜万和哈拉万前田不约而同地搞了一个户外唱诵圣名活动，是不是更多的城市同时唱诵圣名会更好地取悦 Guru 与主？这是第一个问题，还有一点，可否有必要联系各个地方，就是各地搞同样时间唱诵圣名户外提尔塔呢？不说话题。
Chaitanya Rupa Buddha said that
啊，是，对。
the day before yesterday, in northeast China, in Madhuvan, Halavan, simultaneously, we have outdoor Sankirtan activity. The question is that, is it that if many cities simultaneously have Sankirtan, will that better please Guru and Lord? The second part is that, is it necessary to contact different areas to have a Sankirtan at the same time, the outdoor Sankirtan at the same time? Is it necessary to connect with different part to hold Sankirtan at the same time?
I've never heard it done like that. I never heard anywhere that they do like that they have it at the same time. I don't know why you want to do it at the same time. You can do it anytime. Anytime it's auspicious.
就是说，他从来没听说过必须要在同一时间去做，就任何时间的 Sankirtan 全都是吉祥的。
再一个还是他的问题，现在的 Guru 对新人时常被新意的恐惧折磨着，她的丈夫同意让她当奉献者，给他做唱诵几个圣名祭祀，还是让户外还是让外地资深奉献者在一地给他唱给他做，还是在一地给他做呢？你来读吧。
There's a devotee, newfie, who this newfie, this mother is always tortured by the fearness in the mind, and her husband agreed that the local devotee can do Harinam Yagya for her. So Guru, which is better, to let the local devotee to do the Harinam Yagya, or let the senior devotee in the other province, to do this Harinam Yagya for her?
Well, I think the local devotees can do it.
Guru 说当地的奉献就可以做。
You don't need to have senior people do it. Everybody can chant the holy name.
不
But
需要，
the main thing is the devotees chanting should be genuine devotees. They should be following the principles, and then it would have effect.
也需要，就是一定需要资深的外地奉献者，只要是这个当地的奉献者，他是真诚的、遵守原则的去做这个圣名祭，他就会有效果。
下面还是他的问题，就是那个，就是做这个，顾着把你读吧。
就是Chaitanya如果以上的都做了，还用让马普的奉献者在大庙主尼什和Dev神像前帮忙做主尼什和Dev祭祀吗？请故人慈的指导，我们更有效，可以让我们更有效的帮助这处在痛苦当中的他。 Can we also do the Nishinha sacrifice for her in Mahapur?
Yes, you can.
Oh, 可以。
Yeah.
可以。 这会儿还有一个问题, 我家帕夫请教咕噜, 会窥视他种植的花, 盆花和蔬菜如果生虫子，该如何处理？这个呢？感恩Guru仁慈，Hare Krishna.
My Prabhu want to ask Guru if we plant flower and we plant vegetable for Krishna, if there are worms, how to deal with those worms?
Well, wash them off and put them back in the ground.
你就把这些生虫子的蔬菜啊花啊，用水把这些虫子冲掉之后呢，再把这些虫子呢，让它们再回到土壤里。
And tell them these vegetables are for Krishna and they shouldn't bother our vegetables.
然后告诉这些虫子，这些蔬菜和花都是为 Krishna
的，不要来打扰这些蔬菜和花。嗯。嗯哼。顾中队，我来接着问这一下问题，就是这个我今天早上采的鲜花，那个就是用我也洗了在外边那个花，然后洗完了我就一放到神像那个面前。 哎呀，那个那小细从可小可小的了，就是拿纸去给它往外一擦，反正它就得死，就是用眼睛简直就将能看到。这得怎么办呢？现在的花都生虫子了。
Well, you have to spray them with water.
用那个喷壶把它们喷下去。
就刚才我看出他这个说生虫子的问题，现在的花都生虫子了。Because
some insects are so small, it can hardly be seen.
Yes.
And also the outdoor flowers.
Yes. Well, that's everywhere. You can't avoid these things.
嗯，这些不可避免的，到处都一样。
But you can spray them, you know, if you get a fine spray, and then we'll get most of the insects off.
找一个特别好的喷壶，特别有效的把它们有效的喷掉。哦，很好的，感恩咕噜，那个好像没有问题了。哎。
Okay.
不是那个咕噜妈咪，这块有个英文的，下边这个我不知道。嗯，它是，它不是问题，它是
Thank you, Yuvati Sachi. Good day, Thank you very much for your mercy, Hare Krishna.
Okay.
下边这个那个谁这个的，那个 Sumukhi Radha， 这个咕噜。
Sumukhi Radha continue to ask the Guru Mara， 如果这个奉献者不相信祭祀的力量。 也不觉得自己有什么需要忏悔的，只是因为不好意思拒绝奉献者给的提议。这祭祀还有效果吗？
Yes, can still have effect.
可以，会有效果。那是没有问题了。
Krishna can do it. Sometimes Krishna does these things just to convince you that it's real.
就即便他本人不相信，那 Krishna 也会通过这些做法来说服他，告诉他这是确实真实的，真实的，不会骗人的。
Okay, so 我们今天讲到这里，我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们翻译，我们感谢 Padma Mukhi 主持，我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听，我们祝福你，万事如意，团教顺利。
Guru Dev 最辛苦了。
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Guru Mani. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
明白
您的莲花
座。
Jai. Jai.